I actually don't like you.
I know.
Piece of shit. What the fuck is that? It's the fuck is this?
It's Bat McGrogan.
It looks like their teeth are like grills.
They look like those things from that movie Robot with Ewan McGregor or whoever.
Who?
I don't care. I don't know. The movie Robot with the broken robot.
I think I really don't like you because I hate what you're saying right now.
And the street cleaners. And like there's junk scrapper. And he's blue. And there's like a yellow one.
I know that movie.
You know it?
I do.
Who's the lead guy?
I don't... The Blue Robot.
It's not Ewan McGregor.
It's Blue Robot.
Is it Luke Skywalker?
It's Blue Robot.
Mark Hamill.
His name is actually Blue Robot.
God, it's gonna bother me if I don't remember the name, okay?
Then look it up.
Now I'm
ain't nobody stopping you.
I'm playing a game. I'm busy. I want that apple. Mine.
I want that apple.
Oh, God, I got like massive indigestion going on right now.
Good. Probably from those milkshakes.
Oh, Jesus. I think I'm dying.
Stop.
I think I'm dying. Oh, God.
I wish you could all see the face that Bruce is making right now as he fights to
keep
his life in control.
They rolled at me.
Do a barrel roll! I really love Star Fox 64.
You know, I never played it. I mean, I played it, but I didn't like it.
Why?
Because it was confusing.
I bet you're one of those people that like this GameCube version of Star Fox.
The dinosaur one?
Yes.
I fucking love that one. Star Fox Adventures?
I hope everyone is listening to this in fucking disgust.
There are a ton of people out there that love that game.
And there's more people that hate it because
it's stupid. There's people
like
you that are like, oh, it's not Star Fox 64! And they're like, it's not good because it's not Star Fox 64.
No, it's not good because it's a terrible game.
Nah, it's a good game.
There is no redeeming qualities about it.
It was a solid adventure game.
No, it wasn't.
With a decent plot and great mechanics. 10 out of 10.
What game did you play?
I played Star Fox Adventures for the GameCube. And that was a good game.
I played that game through 5 times and hated it all 5 times.
Then why'd you play it 5 times?
I don't know.
Yeah!
I didn't have any games sitting around.
Mm-hmm. You loved it.
I hated it, dude.
You loved it.
I'm looking at you with the straightest face. I hated that game.
You're watching the TV.
I hated that game.
Sandwich. 5 sandwiches. Not you. Ridiculous guy, get a sandwich.
Are you?
Stop! You can't even hold more than... Well, you did hold more than 5.
Don't you tell me what the red and red knight can and can't do. I don't know why I said red.
The red and red knight.
The red and extra red knight.
The extra red is the blood of his enemies. That's alright, you hang up. Can you not? I'm busy.
I want a sandwich.
Yeah!
That's because you're stupid.
Let's keep it going. Hi, Giraffe. How are you doing, bud? No, dude. I like Star Fox Adventure.
It was a terrible game. I even played Star Fox Assault. Still a terrible game.
Star Fox Adventure is literally the only Star Fox game I've ever played all the way through. I did not like...
I can't believe you're allowing that to be your only representation of Star Fox.
I didn't like 64 as a kid. I played it when I was real little, and it was really confusing. I didn't understand the objectives. So
because of your incompetence, you think it's a terrible game.
My incompetence as a 5-year-old, I didn't like it.
And why wouldn't you go try it again? I have it right here.
Yeah, but it doesn't really appeal to me. I'll play the new one when the new one comes out, because it'll look better. But the old one looks like a pile of dog shit.
It does not.
Yes, it does. I'll say that it probably is a good game. It's got great, and it's fucking, it was a staple in N64. But most N64 games look like dog shit.
Okay, yeah, and you know what? In 12 years, most of the Xbox One games will look like absolute dog shit.
I'm not disagreeing with you on that fact. I'm just saying that barely any N64 games are pleasant to look at. The colorful ones are nice.
I like
the polygons look like...
I like looking at Super Mario. I like looking at Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask. I don't mind polygons because I'm not a nitpicky fuckhole.
Maybe there's something wrong with you then.
No.
I think there's something. You should go to a doctor.
I just like my games fun and not caring about the graphics. That's why Nintendo does it right.
I didn't say I didn't like the game.
Don't need fucking hyper-realistic graphics.
I just said that it looks like poop. Banjo-Kazooie looks...
You look like poop. Banjo-Kazooie looks terrible out of all of them.
It looks way better than Mario 64, in my opinion. Mario 64 is a nice, pleasant-looking game.
And a better game.
Not a better game.
It is a better game.
Nah.
It is a better game.
Nah.
It is a better game.
Banjo-Kazooie did everything Mario 64 did right and did it better.
Not true.
Yep.
Not true.
Absolutely.
Name one thing it did better.
They did the world system way better. They added an overworld that was way better and felt more alive. The Jiggies were...
An overworld that was better and more alive. It was Gruntilda's castle.
Exactly.
It was Peach's castle.
Nah, they're way different.
It's the same thing, except Peach's castle has more worlds and more things to explore. It feels like a castle. Her thing looks like a cobbled up piece of horseshit.
But you had like the switches in each level that would add Jiggies to the outside world, and that you had to like.
You had that in Mario 64. What are you talking about? You had buttons that would activate fucking the blocks, the green caps and shit in the overworld.
Yeah, but not on each level.
You would have the fucking, to get the blue cap,
yeah.
You had to go into one of the worlds and activate something to drain the fucking pipage in the overworld. It's the same thing. And Mario 64 did it first.
It's not the same thing.
It is.
No, that's what I'm saying. Mario 64 had the idea first. Banjo-Kazooie did it better. They added, there was one in every level.
Oh, I'm sorry, more is better.
Also,
quality over quantity.
Also,
Bruce.
The bullshit where, like, getting a Jiggy in a level wouldn't take you out of the level. Like, how in Mario 64, every star is, like, its own separate mission.
Yeah, because almost. You need to know how to get the star.
What do you mean? You know how to get the Jiggies.
The Jiggies. The Jiggies were all. They were never solved through a complex puzzle. You just,
yes, they were.
I played through all of Banjo-Kazooie.
When?
It was not. Like. 4 or 5 weeks ago, when I was playing through the Rare replay and trying to get the achievements for it,
there was a ton in Banjo-Kazooie that were puzzles.
They were not.
Yes, there were. Click Clock Wood is an entire.
And
puzzle.
And I'm gonna do you one better.
What's up,
Donkey Kong 64 took Banjo-Kazooie and made it better.
That's debatable on what you define as better, because some people say that game is too heavy on the collectibles and shit.
Donkey Kong 64, it has the same amount of collectibles as Banjo-Kazooie.
Not true.
Alright, Jiggies. Bananas.
No.
Yes.
Yeah, and you have bananas for 4 characters in every mission.
No. Jiggies. Bananas.
Okay.
The colored bananas. Music notes.
How many of the colored bananas were there in color?
It was 100.
Okay.
Jesus Christ. My Darth Vader cardboard cutout just fell over. I don't think he likes this argument very much.
That was the slowest, most depressing thing I've ever seen.
Anyway, colored bananas, music notes.
Okay, 100 each level, that's true.
Okay.
But there's four...
There's five...
There's 100 for each character, isn't there?
There's five, yes.
There's you only 100 notes in each level.
Yes. But here, I'll do you one better. It makes you have to play the game and play all 5 Donkey Kongs. You only had one Banjo.
But you play through the same level 5 times, right?
There's different things for each character to do. There's different ways to get bananas, different ways to get the colored bananas. They're mostly specific to each character. It just made you have to play the game more. You took that and you didn't need it.
What's up?
That fucking chicken wing.
There's no more bosses or nothing. Probably.
Anyway, refute me on that.
What? I'm not saying that you're right, you're stating facts, but some people find it stale to have to replay the same level 5 times with
you don't,
slightly varying
the
puzzles.
Most, it's not slightly varying, I promise you. Alright, listen. Fucking Lanky Kong, he had to fucking, I love the fact, God, piss! Lanky Kong, you had to use the fact that he was super nimble and he could fucking blow himself up like a balloon.
Right.
And the fuck that he had this fucking long arms, his stretchy arms, only he could do certain things, activate
God
certain
damn,
switches. They weren't.
But what was the original argument here? That Banjo-Kazooie didn't have puzzles?
No. That Donkey Kong, that you're saying Banjo-Kazooie took what Mario 64 did and did it better? I'm saying that Donkey Kong 64 took Banjo-Kazooie and did it better.
Alright. I might agree. I can understand where you're coming from with that. But I'm gonna throw this out there. Banjo-Tooie did it better than both of them. Banjo-Tooie perfected the formula.
Donkey Kong 64 didn't go anywhere. It didn't happen to sequel.
Rip, brah.
Fucking, yeah, rip rare.
Yeah.
All right.
Now we have sandwiches, so we can go into the industrial castle and tear down the wall of the ass. Here we'll go.
We can storm the gate! Report back to the command center.
I'm gonna keep going up in the sky. Whee!
I'm just gonna stop.
Yeah!
I'm gonna stop the capture now. I'm gonna stop the capture.
Yeah!
Stop the capture.
Yeah.
I stopped the capture.